Depends on how the voice is, because these voices is.
Yeah.
Okay, this is going to get a little sexual in the middle of it, so just a viewer discretion advised. But I don't know. I'm going back and forth, and I literally have not made a decision. I'm leaving it all up to you for the argument. So here's the girl.
Hey, thanks for everything last night, and I'm really happy that you said that we could still be friends. It's something I'd really like, to continue to be friends. Like those dates that we had, I thought we had such good chemistry. Do you want to have lunch tomorrow?
Hey, nice girl, hope all is well. I can't have lunch tomorrow. I mentioned last night that I'm flying to the East Coast for 2 weeks to see my family and friends. And yeah, we can be friends like I said, but we just saw each other last night, so that's a pretty quick turnaround, no?
Oh right, sorry, I forgot.
Lol, it's okay.
Be safe, kissy face. Like, have a safe flight, I mean, lol. Text me when you land safely. Flying can be stressful. Sorry, I pocket dialed you. What airline are you flying? I'll be able to track the flight to make sure you're okay. I hope you landed safely.
I landed, and it took me a while to get my rental car. Look, I know you came from a good place with your messages, but you really don't have to constantly message me as if we were in a relationship. I need a little bit of space, you know what I mean?
I'm just being a nice, caring friend.
I appreciate the thoughtfulness, but just the rate of messages you send so frequently is honestly overwhelming me. I really don't want to be mean saying this. I hope you understand.
You're like every guy ever on Bumble, gaslighting me, making me feel like I'm crazy. You take advantage of me, I suck your d*** on our second date, and we passionately hugged, and then 1 month later, you throw me away like a piece of trash because you got your fix. You never gave me a chance for a real relationship. Typical.
What? We went on like 8 dates, and we really tried to give everything between us a fair chance to see if it would lead anywhere. I never want to take advantage of anybody. I don't know why you're saying this stuff right now.
You're full of garbage. You're probably already swiping right on new girls. I feel bad for them. What's so funny is that you're gonna regret breaking up with me. You know how many guys are lining up for me? I can't wait to passionately hug a real man for once. A man who's a real gentleman. Who's that flat-chested B-word in your Instagram story? Is she your girlfriend? Have you been cheating on her? I wonder what she's going to think if I told you that I sucked her boyfriend's dick. You pig. No girl is ever gonna make you feel as good as I made you feel. You're gonna come crawling back to me, you moron. Have fun with your East Coast trash. I honestly dodged a bullet with you, a misogynist who only cares about intercourse is what you are. F you, you gaslighting freak.
This is harassment at this point. Stop messaging me. Stop lurking on my social media accounts and following my friends. I'm not gaslighting you. I'm not taking advantage of you. I wasn't cheating on you. You're the only person I went on dates with in a while. And honestly, my experience with you has made me take a break from dating altogether. I hope you find some peace in life and some help.
Stop answering her.
Thank you. Oh my goodness, stop answering these people. Block their numbers. You can block people's numbers. Blocking you blesses me. Stop messaging them. Just stop it.
Blocking you blesses me. All right.
All right, so here's the question. Number one.
Who's worse?
This is the lesser of two evils argument, straight up. If this is a lesser of two evils argument, this would be it. So we can't vote and say they're both terrible. We got to pick one.
Oh, both of them. I already said that both of them are terrible.
So we have to pick one.
Who's the most terrible?
She slept with. How do you sleep with somebody after under 8 dates?
No, second date.
Second.
Well, I thought that was the third. Second was.
Traditionally, third date is sex.
Yeah.
3 dates?
There's a lot that happens between the dates.
Yep.
Where do I live at? I must live in
Indiana. Of course, nowadays people have, you know,
they don't date.
The date.
Let's not go. That's not best.
I would say the guy. I would say the. I'm gonna assume everything and.
Yeah, because him and his telescope just got on my nerves.
Yeah, all the things that.
Sula chose the girl too, but the guy with the telescope was scary. He's worse. So.
Yeah, because they both had stalkerish behaviors.
They were both terrible. Everybody's
just like, I'm blaming the people that kept messaging them. I'm blocking you. You can block people on social media. You can block them out your phone. You don't have to never deal with them. Go get. Oh my gosh, people, stop messaging stalkers.
There's even a way to block their IP address, people.
Exactly. I just had some dude DM me his pictures. I don't want to see you.
This? Do you have anything?
I can't pick. This is a hard one. This is a hard one.
If I have to pick who's the worst, it's going to be the guy. Maybe you're going to call it sexist or whatever, but I view him to be a physical threat. Just because
I have to agree.
I mean, women are also physical threats, but the data is on the side that is more often the man who will lash out faster than the woman will. The girl is more of a psychotic. I hate to say it because it's going to sound really insensitive, but it's like she really kind of fits somebody who's off their meds type of situation where there are some levels of control for her, but she's not following them. So she flips on a dime, right? Mm-hmm. I've encountered women almost as bad as that once or twice in my past. But the guy, he's worse because he really seems like he would try to hurt her.
He ain't gonna mention he had a Mercedes Benz. What does that got to do with anything?
It's the same thing as her saying that she, you know, shined his top. So, I mean, same thing.
Yep.
We got about 50 million analogies about that action. Now we can add shine that top to it.
I almost want to say the one because I put a higher standard to women. Like as a woman, I make women hold to a higher standard. I know I shouldn't, but I do. My gut says two. One is terrible, but I've dealt with so many ones in my life. I'm kind of like, okay. I've dealt with the guys like, you know, I'm just not interested. Well, you ugly anyway. Well, okay, then why did you make a pass? How can I see that? Don't really
that
the classics.
That's a old state thing we do.
Yeah, so
we will come on to you. We'll make you feel like you the greatest thing since sliced bread and everything else until you reject us. Now you the ugliest damn thing since
the mud. And everything else for the same sense. Was I that? But because. For some misogynistic reason, I hold women to a higher standard. I gotta go number two. Because her texting him at the airport, girl. And why did he text her back? Block these people's numbers. I'll
tell you why. Yeah, in my entire life, I think I've blocked two people probably ever. Like, it doesn't even occur to me to block someone. And if I have a direct connection to you, I'm going to try to deflect it away so that there's a easy off ramp so I could see it. That would have probably been the last conversation, that thread that happened. But no, it definitely would have been the last one, that thread that happened.
I've been left on red. I've never blocked anybody.
Oh, it's real easy. I've literally you don't have women DMing you on your Facebook pages, sending you pictures.
I don't.
It's real easy. I don't know why men think, oh, let me send her pictures. I don't want to see
because
you.
It works.
It don't work on me.
It doesn't work on you. But you understand the guys who are out there doing that. Guys hunt in two methods, right? There's a law of large numbers, and then there's a target approach, Okay. So the law of large numbers is you holla at anyone who remotely appeals to you.
Right.
And if you talk to, if you shoot your shot at 100, you're going to get at least 5. That's 5 people. That's a good catch. And then there's the targeted approach, which is when, you know, you actually like a particular person. So you figure her out and you maneuver to get as close as possible to her. So both are always in play. So that's why.
Yeah.
And if women would stop feeding strays, you wouldn't have as much of it happening.
Ah, y'all would have to agree with you there. You are apps 1,000,000% right.
Make an efficient expedition. There is trawling, which is basically the equivalent of you throw a net into the water and you grab whatever it is that you're going to grab. And you sort it out after you pull that net of a whole bunch of fish in. Then there are fishing. You go to a certain area with a certain pole, with a certain bait, because you try to catch a certain fish. Tracy, what I'm saying is you, that DM that was to you was the same I guarantee.
Oh, yeah, I guarantee.
I guarantee you that message that was sent to you was sent to several people that day.
Oh, yeah.
Who I mean, this is like soccer guy. I mean, it happens. Not all the time, but yeah, I know how to block people.
They do it to my wife. They do it to my daughter.
But y'all never received a from random text or a woman. I can make your life happy.
Women don't do that. Not the type of women that would ever think they could have my attention.
And the funny thing about it is because I make it perfectly clear how much I love Foxy and how Foxy is in my life, so I really honestly think nobody would even try.
That doesn't work, Mama.
I can say everybody knows that I'm with Foxy, and so you wouldn't even try. Or, Molly, you just not that damn attractive. I can take
Marlon, it. Somebody no, out there just went challenge accepted.
Yep, because it's women out there desperate in these streets.
The game is different. The game is so much different for men and women. You know, I have led my life by this rule. Don't create questions where questions don't exist. That is what I truly believe. Okay. So and I also know I have a weak no reflex from back when I was single. So when you understand that about yourself, I make sure I'm not in environments where I'd have to deal with something like that. Right? I'm not at the bar. I'm not at the club.
A weak node reflex did I hear that right?
A weak no reflex. Right? If you appeal to
say
me
no.
And you come on to me, I'm probably gonna go, oh, okay. Right?
So
keep all that at arm's length. I don't have random women around me. That's just not an option.
That lesson that you just said, because
everybody's
different, but I'm telling you why.
There are certain people you need to literally be direct with. So when somebody's coming out to you and you say, I'm flattered, that wasn't a no.
That's not a no. But right. The point I was making to you, Marlon, is it's not even a matter of attractiveness, it's a matter of availability.
Exactly.
So you have much fewer people to have to turn down if you stay away from environments which would make you an option. For example, I consider myself to be at least moderately attractive. I never wear a wedding ring. I haven't worn a wedding ring since I worked for a big box store where we stopped wearing our rings because you can get your finger stuck in the baler and it rip your finger off. I haven't worn a ring since then.
They already have that written in the rules that you cannot wear jewelry.
I knew it was coming too, and it's still, dang.
Yeah, but I'm just saying though, I make sure I govern myself in a particular way. I don't have to worry about people coming on to me. I don't have to worry about somebody sending me a direct message because my messages are set up in such a way you can't message me unless you're a friend, and I don't add a lot of friends. See what I'm saying? So there's so many things you can do to limit it. Yep. And then as a guy, women aren't hunting the same way. Women are hunting more than they used to. Okay. But you have to be in their vicinity for them to do it. Women, on the other hand, man, it's sick. Like just random dudes You ain't even met him. He just somehow found a way to harass you.
I'd like to know you. Well, I want to know you, Block. I know how to block.
Trace Thompson said that on
me. Take some time, maybe, before you allow some texts or. See, what I see as a major problem here with the second where the girl was saying, I bet you're already swiping right.
She's okay. Talking to him on social media.
And she has no self-esteem. She even said, you're just like everybody else on Bumble.
Did we not hold this conversation? Did we not hold this conversation last night when we were sitting there talking about relationships, a inner workings, like you're in a relationship. You established as a relationship, but it's like 4 or 5 months and you're acting like it's 2 years and you're engaged and you're married. It's like, wait,
no, what? I got one better than that. First date. What do you think about getting married? Dude, I just met you.
Tracy, oh, you I know what? Know your, Tracy, I don't that know right there. Name. I don't even know your shoe size. What the hell are we talking about?
Well, one thing I'm gonna say there, man, because I observe how single people talk, and mm-hmm. and y'all, they're confusing as hell, right? So they're not dating to date, and the traditional differences between men and women are starting to break down. So generally, at least how when I came up, I know back in the day, guys date to date, right? It's something for us to do. We like interacting with different women. And then we're also always trying to find a way to get some sex, right? So that was just what we did. We could be dating you for days, weeks, months, because it's not a constant thing, is just dating. If you're my lady, if you're my girlfriend, it will be made clear that you're my lady. And at that point, I'm actually dating you. And you don't got to worry about nobody else unless I'm a cheater. And then, you know, that's a different thing. But there's phases and stages to everything, yeah. Right? Everybody who that you date doesn't become your girlfriend. Everybody that's your girlfriend doesn't become your fiance. And everybody who's mm-hmm. your fiance may or may not become your wife, right? We whittle mm-hmm. that stuff down.
Yeah.
Where single people are right now, especially at our age group, is really confusing because the women will say, well, I'm not dating just to waste my time. Mm-hmm. So now they want to know what your religious background is, what kind of job you got,
what's your credit what score? This,
what that, right? And I'm like, wait a minute. I just wanted to feed you.
Yeah, right? I just wanted to go to the movies. Dang, girl, sit right? down.
I just what wanted to hang out with you and see you smile and see if I can get in your pants. That right was here, my whole plan.
Well, don't say that second part.
This is what bothers me, not you saying it. It's what you said. I'm not dating just to date. I need to know where this going. Date I need going. To know that this, and I have to look at that person and go, so you think you're fine with everything that's right with you?
Well, like, to them, you know,
yeah. So you don't think there's any changes that need to happen with you for us to move on? I can accept the fact that I may need to make some changes and adjustments in this relationship because of me, but you're already jumped over. Hell, I'm good with the way the hell I am. So
yep,
we need to know where the hell we going with this. Like, wait a minute. You literally have taken.
I'm not even talking about.
Relationship is a nuance. There's an.
I'm not even talking about you've been dating for a while, Marlon. I'm talking about like first date.
First date.
People are interviewing each other on their first
What's
date.
Your credit score?
The very first, you could take this from the first date to 6 weeks. It's still the same equivalent of there's a nuance in every relationship and you figure it, there isn't. So you need to know where this relationship going. Hell, I don't know. Where do you think this relationship is going? Well, I want to get married. Oh, so it's really all because of you. You don't even know my parents' names.
I don't know your last name. Bro, I'm saying, you like macaroni and cheese. I don't know.
Even what you're saying is Yeah, even what you're saying is further out, bro. I'm talking about right now. Mm-hmm. People are dating to get married. That's why they are dating. The end of the story is, are we going to get married? So when I'm dating you, I'm like, our first date is to figure out if I feel like you could be my next husband or you could be my next wife. Oh my We're skipping God. All the steps. We're trying to see mathematically, will you fit what I'm trying to build? And that's it, right? And I'm like, whoa.
I don't even know if
first,
I like
find
you
out
or
if
not.
You enjoy each other's company.
Thank you.
I just want to eat my steak.
I just came right? to watch a movie. Oh, wow. That's all I wanted to do. I ain't trying to marry you.
Parker, one of the absolutely sweetest, loveliest relationships I knew, the guy was old enough to absolutely be her father, somewhere in between her father and grandfather. And they had kids. They stayed together till death did them part.
No, that one didn't seem like it was too hard, given what you just said.
Oh, oh Tess, you know
that
what?
That was bad. That was oh, bad.
Tess. She was in her 20s. She was in her 60s. They had...
Anna, don't just ignore him.
A few decades, thank you.
Yeah, no, yeah, that's... Look, everybody's age an individual and everything is unique. Age does matter because we two does. Different that I mean two completely different eras we're coming up in, right?
Mm-hmm.
But sometimes you'll find a match. I will never be the one to advocate for a 40-year difference.
I'm just saying you, don't be surprised if they can be out there.
They can because especially if everybody's upfront about what it is that we after, and I'm not saying this is the case for them, but at that kind of an age difference,
I'm going to make some assumptions. I'm in generation
one
X,
assumption,
and you in the greatest generation. That might not work.
Anna, one assumption. Be mad at somebody me. Might have some daddy issues. Second issue. Somebody might have a youth interest, not fetish, just an interest. Mm-hmm. So there's a lot of things that be going on. And so long as everybody's cool with the dynamics of that relationship and it works for those two people, hey, more power to you. At least you are both grown. Good luck to you, right?
Yep.
But I don't even advocate for two young people to get married before they're 25 just because we change too much.